complete opposites. Like they are, they're from like completely different worlds. But they love each other so much. And you, Jamie comes to her with this news that he wants to be a drag queen, and she does not understand why or what a drag queen is or how any of that works. You know, everybody has that thing that they want to do that they don't do. They worry about what people might say. And I hope that this film gives them a little bit of courage to do whatever makes them the happiest. Anything that scares me is always good, because that means that I'm going out of my comfort zone, I think. And I was very scared to do this project, but I'm so, so glad that I did.
So firstly, Lauren, a huge congratulations for everybody's talking about Jamie. I really love the authenticity that you brought in the film and the fact that you are also an anchor being Jamie's friend. I'm so excited to know how that friendship will unfold. So on that note, a huge welcome to Times of India, E-Times, and we are so happy to have you joining with us today.
Thank you for having me. I'm so excited to be talking to you.
So what made you say an absolute yes to the film, and which was the most fun part shooting it?
The thing that made me say yes was I'd watched a recording of the show before, whilst I was auditioning, and I just remember thinking how much fun these actors looked like they were having. And I just remember this story and these characters being filled with so much joy, and I just couldn't wait to be a part of it. And I also think for me personally, you know, seeing a role in theatre that was specifically for, you know, a Middle Eastern or North African or South Asian girl was so special, and so having the privilege of playing her in this movie was like indescribable.
True. So what was your biggest takeaway from Priti and Jamie's friendship?
I think that the thing that I really love about them too is that they are complete opposites. Like they're from like completely different worlds. But they love each other so much. And you know, Jamie comes to her with this news that he wants to be a drag queen, and she does not understand why or what a drag queen is or how any of that works. But she listens and she learns because she cares about him so much. And that's all that matters to her at the end of the day, is that she can see how happy this will make her friend. And anything else is just extra.
So, you know, so many LGBTQ movies have been explored before. So how important will this film be to the community?
I hope that it is important. I hope that it resonates with people from this community and from people in general. I think that it's, as much as the story is quite specific about this boy from Sheffield in the UK who wants to be a drag queen, it's also really universal. You know, everybody has that thing that they want to do that they don't do. They worry about what people might say. And I hope that this film gives them a little bit of courage to do whatever makes them the happiest.
So Lauren, being a part of this film, what is your perception of a drag queen? Has your viewpoint changed or affected in a certain way?
Well, I didn't know much about drag going in. I'd heard of RuPaul's Drag Race, but I hadn't seen any. And when I found out I got this job, I purposefully didn't kind of research and learn a lot about that side of it, because Priti doesn't know anything about drag. So I got to learn about drag the same way that Priti does, through watching Jamie. I got to watch Max perform, and I got to watch and meet our wonderful drag queens and meet people like Bianca Del Rio, and who better to learn drag from, really. And so now I'm obsessed with.
So, you know, Lauren, another thing, your debut also allows you to pave a path for South Asian representation for women on the big screen. So as an actor, what will be your priorities to maintain your individuality?
Yeah, I think that definitely going into this, you know, and throughout doing this press, people have been telling me that I'm making it like it's quite a big deal to be playing this role as this one of the leads in this film. And I think that the thing that I can do to maintain that is to not think about the pressure of representing a whole community, because, you know, that's an issue within itself. No white person is going on to set and wondering and worrying about the fact that they're representing all white people and worrying that they won't do a good job. And so all that I can do is tell the stories that I want to tell in the most authentic way that I can, and hope that that resonates with people. And if it doesn't, then I hope that there is a wider span of representation for our community so that everybody can feel like they have their stories told.
This is a very sweet thought, and I like the way you have put it forward.
Thank you very much.
So moving on, what are the kind of projects you are looking forward to?
I am just looking forward to anything that is exciting, anything that scares me is always good, because that means that I'm going out of my comfort zone, I think. And I was very scared to do this project, but I'm so glad that I did. And I just love any work that helps you transform, you know, these wonderful actors like Tilda Swinton and Florence Pugh, who every single role that they take is so different. That's what excites me the most, I think.
Mm-hmm. So what piece of advice would you give to young actresses of color who want to make their mark in the industry?
Sometimes it can be a bit disheartening when you're not seeing your stories being told in the mainstream, but there are people who are telling them, and there are people who want to tell them. You know, your stories are more than interesting enough to be told, and you will find people who value your work and who support you. You might just have to look a little bit harder for it.
So thank you so much, Lauren, for doing this with me. Thank you so much for taking out time for this. I am really looking forward to seeing more of you on the screen, and all the best for the film.
Thank you so much. Lovely to speak with you.